This is the Billy T. Detroit Radio Podcast.
Billy T. Detroit Radio. News, sports, entertainment, and a little foolishness.
Always a little foolishness. And we are back. Welcome back to Billy T. Detroit Radio, where we try to entertain you and inform you and really just have a little fun. And as we get started, this is show number 39.
39?
Show number 39.
We've done more shows than Rocky Road have been alive.
Whatever.
It's August 18th, and it has been a crazy week on planet Earth, starting with the riots. Let's call it what it was in Charlottesville, Virginia, the protest and the unfortunate killing of a young
terrorist,
lady.
The terrorist attack, since we're calling it what it was.
Let's call it what it is, a terrorist attack. And, of course, Donald Trump said, well, hey, everyone, all sides were at fault. He has identified with the white nationalist by saying they want to take down the beautiful statues. The statues are beautiful, and they want to take them down. He has blatantly said, it's okay what you guys do. The KKK, the Nazis, the nationalists, it's all fine. They're not doing anything wrong.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's without using those exact words, he sent the signal out so strongly that David Duke said, thank you. Donald Trump did a great job.
Well, you know what? David Duke said before it all happened, when it was first starting, that this is Trump's dream come alive.
Mm-hmm. And it is. And it's, so, and it's very much alive.
He was already embraced by them. So it's... That was ugly as can be. Everything wrong with America was right in your face.
In your face. Are we surprised?
And it's still there.
But are we surprised that the racist, let's say it like it is, are coming out in droves? Are we really surprised?
No. But the question is, it was a question posed to me, is it better? Is it better that we can see them as opposed to them being snakes in the grass?
We knew they were there.
But now they're out in the open. Now they're all plastered on Facebook. We've put faces and names with people.
Right. I don't know if that's better or not. It's a tough question because, and then too, you come to this political correctness thing, which gets on your nerves, of course. But the reality is, if it is suppressed to a point where everyone says, "Hey, that's not cool," when other white folks say, because when you looked at that video in Charlottesville, right, that was all white folks.
Of course.
And I couldn't tell who was who. just fighting. But when white folks tell other white folks that's not cool, then they have to back off of it. And now it's been unleashed, like the gates have been opened, and it's cool to be racist now. Donald Trump has made it okay and acceptable.
But is it better to see your enemy?
We know the enemy.
Is it better? No, we don't.
We know the
enemy. Because like you said, you couldn't tell one from the other.
And during that fight, but
until they fought. Well, I'm saying they're not fighting, when they're standing beside each other, and they're two cops, you don't know which one
is good, which one's bad.
Is wearing the hood.
The only problem is that I think it emboldens them more, and it encourages other people to join that.
Well, they've been recruiting.
They've been recruiting, and they're doing a damn good job of
it. I just saw something the other day that someone put up a picture of a business card. From the leader of the nationalists, they're recruiting in their neighborhood.
Yeah, in Michigan.
It was left on our car.
In Michigan. Yeah, they're everywhere. And it's not a surprise that they're in Michigan. Indiana was a big, huge Klan state.
Absolutely.
Back in the day, and probably still is.
The last known public hanging was in Marion, Indiana.
How Michigan is known for their Klans.
That's true.
You know, right outside of Lansing.
Wyandotte, Michigan,
really?
Has been identified as one of the largest
Klan areas.
Yeah.
Wow.
Klan concentration.
That's a little close to home right there.
That's very close to home.
Oh, I thought it was like out there, like near Okemos or.
That's how.
That's what I thought. Mm-hmm. But you know, if you want to ask me, if anybody's asking my input,
sure.
We always want your input, Rocky Road.
I feel as if, I'm definitely not shocked. To me, everybody's under suspicion. I say this all the time in my videos, to proven innocent, everybody's under suspicion. And I think if you're really good with reading energy, you know, then you would really feel that something ain't right about this person.
Yeah.
And I feel that a lot at my place of employment, which I won't disclose.
Yes.
But
yes.
I can feel the energy. It's very toxic. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
So why won't you disclose it? You don't want us to know which McDonald's you work at?
Oh, I don't work at no McDonald's. Don't play with me.
Stop it.
Look, the foolishness about to come out on the Billy T Show right now.
And the big news,
Can I say something before you get to the big news? Because I do want to say, like I said, it brings out the ugly part of our country in every way. But there's something else. It's not only did it bring it out then, but when you look at in the aftermath, the next day, I think it was it Charlotte, North Carolina, where they took down the statue?
They put the rope around it.
Okay, so the black lady that climbed to the top and put the rope on it was arrested.
Nobody else.
But these white guys that they have on camera beating this man almost to death, young man in the garage,
I saw that.
None of them arrested yet.
No. But you pull down a statue, you're going to jail.
Not a single one of them arrested.
Once again, the double standard in this country.
It brought out one of the ugliest things about this. Everything wrong with this country. You saw it.
You've seen it this week.
Yeah.
In full focus.
And you know it's going to come back up, so I'm going to let you move on to the big story.
It's going
to
come. This is just the beginning. I think it's going to get real ugly before it gets better. Much more uglier than it already is. Yes. But speaking of ugly, Steve Bannon is out at the White House, the president's personal confidant
and advisor. Ugly.
This dude, man, he looks like death, warmed over. He is out, and the question now is what's going to happen when he gets back to Breitbart? He says he's going to going to war with the White House.
Woo!
Oh, he's going to expose some stuff.
He knows too much. You let him in and then you kick him out?
Well, go ahead and enter the shade room then, Mr. Bannon. Go ahead then. World star, the shade room.
It's going down. It is going down.
Holy smokes.
Also, terror attacks in Spain yesterday. A truck ran over a crowd of people, killed about 13 people, injured about 50 people. They didn't mess around over there. They shot them guys. They killed about 4 or 5 suspects. So
damn.
It's like with the quickness. Mm-mm. And also in Finland today, some mass stabbings took place, and the police shot and arrested. They shot him in the leg. They didn't kill the guy. I don't know how many people were stabbed, but it's just the world has gone completely mad. I don't know what the hell's going on.
I want to know if Donald Trump is running a government temp agency up there.
Who's next?
Mm-mm. I don't know. I'm starting to think we need to go to the whole eye for an eye.
Now, slow down there, young lady. Whoa.
Here she comes.
You have the story on Bannon. What's the whole story? I know you had that ready to go. So,
as you say, he's no longer the chief strategist. His resignation was submitted on August the 7th. Mm. The announcement.
August the 7th?
The 7th.
Really?
The announcement was postponed due to the situation in Charlottesville.
Okay. Mm.
He has been in this position over Trump's draconian policies since January 20th. Mm. It's been said that Trump let Bannon go.
Mm-hmm.
On Friday, there was a lunch with Trump and 21 administrative officials, and Bannon was not on the list.
Oh.
So there's the story on that.
Mm. You can't come, Steve Bannon.
You can't come.
You know, you are unfit. You and your fake news.
And man, this stuff is getting so crazy. I don't even know anymore.
Yeah.
The Trump show continues.
The Trump show.
Every day
it's something new. It's incredible. This is like the most chaotic presidency in my lifetime.
I've ever seen. Yeah.
And you notice he always brings up President Obama. He even did in that speech.
Yeah. Or Hillary. One of the
what is this about?
Yeah. Obama, it's Obama's
fault. It wasn't my son talking to the Russians. It was Obama's son.
Obama did it. It's Hillary and Obama. They teamed up against me. I took them all down.
Oh, my God. Just get it.
I won by record numbers.
But I'm going to fix it like you've never seen before.
We're going to win so much, you're going to get tired of winning. Mm-hmm. I don't know. But I tell you, man, the talk shows are having a field day with this guy.
You can't help it.
All you can do is laugh at it at this point, but it is getting real serious.
It's very serious.
Let's pray for the country to come together, because it's being torn apart at the seams.
And well, it has to. It has to become chaos for things to get better. Things always get worse before they get better. So,
Breaking news.
What?
Congratulations to the KKK. Their petition to have a rally in Southside Chicago is approved.
Oh, good. All right, there you go.
You know what? Have a nice night.
Yeah. Okay. Now, I want to see that one, you know? It's Billy T. Detroit Radio. Thank you so much for listening. We're always here. And you can always find us. And we'd like to hear from you. If you are watching on Facebook or listening on Facebook, leave a comment for us, okay? Flavor there.
Don't
Side
do it
effect.
There.
You don't know nothing about that right
do
there,
Do it there.
Woo, always there. Billy T. Detroit Radio. Squirrel is in the building.
What up, Dove? What
Rebecca
up, Dove?
Rebecca is in the building.
No,
also known as?
Rocky Road Productions, LLC, Porch Talk.
LLC. Woo-hoo. That means you're licensed? You're incorporated?
What? Yeah, I got an LLC
Rocky
going
Road
on.
Rocky Road Productions.
I ain't just throwing it on there for giggles.
She
and
official,
play.
Man.
Yeah. I had to drive up to Okemos to file the paperwork.
Really?
Yeah.
And you made it past Howell without getting...
Yeah. Hey, and my husband was driving, and he's dark-skinned.
Ooh, dark-skinned.
Oh, look out now.
She had to throw it in there.
Yeah.
Okay, I got
she
you.
Had to throw that in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, does that matter?
No wonder she ain't want no coffee.
Let me tell you something. I like dark. That's why I married dark.
Okay, all right.
No cream, baby. No cream.
Well, she's light bright.
Yes, yes.
And that we know, you know.
Exactly.
You know. Contrast. We like contrast.
Right.
All right, what do you got for us, Becky?
Listen, you guys already know Mary J. Blige is suffering with a divorce. And on top of that.
Keanu, he getting all that money, ain't he?
I guess. She owes an approximate $6.5 million in back taxes.
What?
Oh my goodness.
What?
Yep, Mary's gotta pay that IRS.
Are you kidding me?
That's on top of the $30,000 per month she has to pay Kendu.
Oh
wow.
Dude, let me marry one of these chicks so I can get $30,000 a month.
I heard about that because I saw her on the Today Show and she was saying
about her tax problem?
Yeah, and she said, I'm not gonna cry, I'm not gonna cry, I'm never gonna shed no tears.
Oh my god.
Squirrel. Okay, so here's my question. Mary J, Floyd Mayweather, they're saying he owes taxes, back taxes. Mm-hmm. What's wrong with these rich people not paying? Floyd got way too much money. Mary May has some issues. Floyd's got way too much money to not pay his taxes.
Well, some
how
of us.
How you going to fill out a tax form that can't read?
Hey, be nice.
Well, some of us ain't good at paying bills. So if you're not good at paying bills, just because you get money don't mean you become good at paying bills.
But when you got that
you
much money, you can pay somebody to
do
pay
that.
Your bills.
Yeah.
Pay somebody
like,
to know
dude,
how to do
it. You're my accountant. How much do I owe? Okay, boom, write a
maybe
check.
Maybe they don't and trust them. You guys have seen so many people with money go broke because of their accountants and people handling their money.
Wait a minute. Too much
if
money,
they mess up something like that, it is Trump's America. Just tell him you're fired.
Well, listen, he can pay it back with this McGregor fight. Okay?
Yeah, that's why he's fighting. That's,
I believe that too.
Part of the fight is because he owes
this
money.
I think that is the only reason he took that fight.
Speaking of the fight, you said the celebrities are coming.
They're
coming out.
So the celebrities to be at the Mayweather and McGregor fight include Angelina Jolie.
She's not coming.
It says
Angelina is not coming.
This is what
is she gonna wear lipstick?
Says. Angelina Jolie, Drake, Elon Musk, Diddy, Mark Wahlberg, Denzel
Elon
Washington,
Musk. Denzel, they'll all be there. They go to all the fights.
Charlize Theron, LL Cool J, Jamie Foxx, LeBron James, Bob Kraft, Rick Ross, Adam Levine, Michael Bay, Avicii, and Jeff Beecher.
I don't know who that is, but all those other guys going to be there.
And they're saying the others that haven't There are others that haven't been disclosed yet that they're not aware of.
I'm sure.
Other celebs will be watching the fight from party venues.
Now, they say that the fight is not selling out. The venue itself is not selling out because the ticket prices are too high.
Yeah.
Lower the tickets.
And nobody want to see it.
Somebody wants to see it.
They want to see that garbage.
I think pay-per-view is going to be big.
It's going to be. That's a clown show, man.
Yeah.
Did you see the video of McGregor training?
Yeah.
Doing the Three Stooges with his little dance.
Man.
And now they got the McGregor challenge.
He didn't have on a kilt.
Come on.
No.
He's going to get killed.
And a bagpipe.
He's going to get killed in the ring. But anyway, enough about that garbage of a story.
Okay, what you got?
I'm tired of that story.
Okay, what you got?
I'm done with the NFL right now.
Okay, now let's talk about that. There's a boycott going on.
I'm in.
Black out the NFL.
Look, can I just say, seriously, this hit me like about probably close to 2 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
It just, out of the blue, and I don't know, I can't really say out of the blue, it just overwhelmed me. I just came to the realization that it was time for me to say, you know what? I've fought it because I love football and I want to be a part of it. I want to watch it. I love fantasy football. But I really have to stand up and say no more.
So you're saying you're not going to watch any football this season?
I'm not watching it, college football. I said I will enjoy my football on Saturdays.
There you go.
But I will not be enjoying my football on Thursdays, Sundays, or Mondays.
Well, I never did enjoy it on Thursday. Stopped watching pretty much on Monday and watched very little on Sunday for the last 2 or 3 years. Okay,
well, so
an unannounced boycott because I think that the game is watered down. I don't think it's as good as it used to be, and I think it's almost getting like the NBA where you can almost predict what's going to happen, which has never been in football. But also what they're doing I know who's going to be in the finals. So anyway, I work on Sundays, and for the last 3 years or so,
I don't know who's going to be in the finals.
It's on in the studio, and that's about as close as it gets. I'm not paying attention. I'm not keeping up. I don't care who wins. I watch it if I'm there kind of thing.
I hear you.
So I'm okay with the boycott. My question is, and here's the thing with NFL. They're mad at Colin Kaepernick. Nobody wants to hire him because he is a distraction. He's going to hurt our fan base. Our viewers are going to. And the whole thing is, they don't care about you black folks either because you make up about 15% of their base. And they don't care. They will cater to these white racist people who are worried about a young black man taking a knee versus somebody beating their wife, killing somebody, driving drunk, doing all these other things. But this young man who took a knee, which is your right in this country, that's what that flag is for you to have that right to protest and speak your mind. But they hate it because he's a young black man with a big afro.
And they don't care about us.
And they don't care about us. So is it going to make a difference is the question.
I want to say this. First of all, and this is a stupid question, but give me a serious answer. Are white people just inherently dumb? Are black people inherently smarter than white people? Because if the answer is no, then why the hell don't they get it? Why do all the black people understand what the protest is about and all the white people seem
don't get
to
it.
Not get it?
They don't get it.
They think it's about the flag. They think it's about
the military.
They don't understand. For some reason, they so smart. And I don't think they're dumb.
Cognitive dissonance.
I don't think they're stupid. But they want to pretend they don't get it.
To the fact that they don't get it.
They change the
narrative.
And they change the narrative.
They change the narrative.
Cognitive dissonance.
And they change the narrative so that they can have an excuse to not support it.
Exactly.
But let me say this.
Exactly.
When you look at what happened in Charlottesville a week ago.
That tells the whole story.
And you look at the response of the President of the United States.
There it is.
Did Colin Kaepernick have a case?
Of course he does.
Okay. Is he so wrong, so much worse than a drug addict that you let back in the league, than a wife beater that you let back in the league, than a rapist that you let back in the league? Is he so much worse than these people?
Of course not.
Okay.
But the whole thing is, again, He is a young black man who has the nerve to speak his mind. And he did it in the most, I think, professional.
I say it's the cause.
Professional.
I don't think it's about him. It's the cause. It's the cause it's, that the NFL is against.
It's black folks.
That's right.
They don't and let care me say about, this about you, this Negro.
Is what, this
you
is
don't
what,
you don't understand
no,
yet.
No, let me help you.
You Negroes ain't
say
understand
this.
Yet. They don't care about you. It's
let
about money and money really only.
Let me say this.
They don't care about us.
Let me say this. Here's what I'm trying to keep a level here, not get riled up. But this was my last straw. When you think about it, we went through this not too long ago over the black quarterback issue. They said black men were too dumb to play quarterback. And then eventually they finally got past that. We didn't. We fought, we bickered, but we watched. We still supported. Then it came to the black coach. The black man was too dumb to coach.
And
NFL.
We proved we could do that.
And then we bickered and we bitched and we moaned, and eventually they got over that. We supported through all the way through it. Here we go again.
Here we
now
go
they're
again.
Saying the black families don't matter.
They
black
don't.
People being
they don't.
Killed in the streets
they
don't matter.
Don't you get it?
Strike three for me.
It's it.
I'm done. I don't want go. I don't I can't support the message that we can give a man, a murderer, a second chance. We can give a dog killer, a felon, a second chance. We can give a drunk driver a second chance. We can give a rapist a second chance,
a wife beater
a second chance. But a man that stands up for black people being killed in
the
streets
police.
And nobody being held accountable
is a problem.
The unforgivable sin.
Yeah.
I cannot support that message. And that's the reason I said, you know what? I just can't do it. I'm out.
There you go.
I'm out. If Kaepernick finds a job, I may or may not come back. I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to feel about it because
right.
it shouldn't come
this point,
to this.
At this point, we already see how they really feel.
Exactly.
So whether he gets a job or not, that sentiment is still there.
It's still there.
So that has not changed.
Exactly.
So it's got to be a lot of change. This country, it's just the scab is being pulled back. And we're seeing what America is really about. If you didn't know, as young people may not have known, this is what it's really about. Okay,
yes.
Nothing has changed.
No,
a few of us have elevated our state, our station in life, but most of us are still in the same situation, and we are still being disrespected, mistreated, and pushed aside, just like it always has been.
Well, and you know what makes it worse now? I'm sorry. Just one thing. What makes it worse now is that it's on camera now. You can see it.
Right.
You can't say that we're making it up. You can't say that we're lying. And you still
don't
let
care.
It happen.
You still let it happen. You still don't care.
Well,
there it is.
I guess it's safe to argue that these people are not productive because as human beings, we're supposed to evolve. We're evolving. They are not.
Billy T. Detroit Radio. Free your mind. Express yourself.
T Detroit Radio. News, sports, entertainment, and a little foolishness.
And we back. And a little bit of foolishness. Of course, we can't let the show go by without a little entertainment news. And
for some reason, that music always makes me want to tap dance.
Tap dance?
What it is. I just feel like,
do your thing, brother. Whatever floats your boat, as they say. As the kids are saying now. Whatever floats your boat.
Oh, the kids are saying that now?
The kids are saying that.
It sounds like old kids.
And they old, but they kids. So Jay-Z, of course, on his new album, 444.
Jigga.
He mentions Kanye. He talks about all kinds of stuff. And I've been listening to that album in the car last couple of days. That's a dope album.
It's dope.
Oh, my God. You, come on, man.
Yeah, my husband about drove me crazy listening to
it. Did he? So anyway, he's talking about Kanye here. This is from Fader Magazine. And he's been releasing Tidal exclusives, of course. So then the talk turns to Kanye.
Ooh.
When Jay is discussing Kill Jay-Z, the first track.
Okay. Well, Jay does mention Ye in that.
Yeah, he mentions a lot of stuff. He says that the song ideas are bigger than their beef. It's me talking to myself and taking ownership of some of the things I've done. But he confirmed that some of the song's lyrics reference Kanye.
Mm-hmm.
But it's to make a broader point. He says it's not even about Kanye. It's not about Kanye. It really isn't. his name is there just because it's just the truth of what happened. But the whole point is, you got hurt because this person was talking about you on stage. But what really hurt me was, you can't bring my kids and wife into it.
Oh,
Kanye's my little brother. He's talked to me. He's talked about me 100 times. He's keeping track. Sounds like Jay is keeping track.
That's 99. A lot of time.
I guess he had 99 problems.
And then Kanye is one.
That was good. I liked it.
He made a song called Big Brother. That was a good song, too. He said, we've gotten past bigger issues, but you brought my family into it. Now it's a problem with me.
Oh.
That's a real, real problem. And he knows it's a problem. And I'm coming after you, Kanye. If I see you on the street, I'm going to smack you in the head.
Ooh.
Oh, my
Did
goodness.
He say that? Wait a minute.
I don't
he
think
didn't.
He said that.
You done ran out.
Okay, I got a little carried
and
away
I don't
there.
Know whose voice you were just
I
doing
don't either.
There, that didn't
Charles
sound
Barkley.
A damn thing like Kanye or Jay-Z.
Charles Barkley.
That little gangster, I don't know. Hey, new Kaprazzi. We're going to smack him upside the head a couple times. Oh, I don't goodness. Know, but it's just interesting that it's such a big deal. But basically, Kanye just said, man, you don't bring the kids over. Our kids ain't never played together.
Mm.
It's kind of sad, really, if they're supposed to be best friends. Their kids won't play, haven't played
well,
together.
Well, because Jay-Z and them, don't they live out west? Didn't they just buy their house? They closed
they
the deal
just
in their house
in
today.
In L.A., but I'm saying.
Yeah, so they live out west.
They have private jets.
But
so does Kanye lives out west, too.
But the kid's name is North.
Oh, my God. Come on now.
Oh, what are we going to do? Oh and Corn Dog's God. Not even here.
But listen, though, remember it used to be the all that smoke about Beyonce not liking Kim.
And I think that's got a lot to do
so
with it.
So that would have a lot to do with it because, you know, he's got a role with his wife.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying?
You got to do what the wife say. That's
you know.
But he can't sneak away and let the kids play together.
But he still ain't got to say nothing about it. I mean, he still can keep my wife and kids out of this.
Yeah, well, we'll see what happens. All right, Becky, what you got?
Well.
Good hair.
Well,
Becky with the good
50
hair.
Cent.
50.
50, 50.
He admits to leaking those
He's
episodes.
Leaking? He's leaking. I knew there was something wrong with that boy.
He's not leaking. 50. He admits to leaking the episode. He says here on the Shade
so,
Room.
So he leaked the episodes of Power.
Yes.
Okay.
He says Power ratings up another 10% for episode 408. They glad I leaked it now. Laugh out loud. Hashtag Savage Life. Now watch what I do on BT, hashtag 50 Central BET. So some dude chimes in and says, I been said that you leaked it. And 50 says, man, you snitching. What you mean you been said I leaked it?
Wait a minute. He just said he leaked it. Shut up, 50 Cent.
Right. He always acting a fool.
He's the worst.
Why you snitching?
Right.
Didn't you just
snitched on yourself.
Right.
Oh, my goodness. So anyway, do you guys watch Power?
I do.
Let me just say this. I no longer have stars. I got stars because I wanted to see Power.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I binge watched the first three seasons.
Okay.
And then I lost stars. And now I got another new season coming out.
Well,
and I haven't seen it yet.
He leaked it so you can get it.
Well, yeah.
Am I the only person? This might is gonna everybody going to beat me up. But I've watched one episode of Power and one episode of Game of Thrones.
Let me just say this.
Oh, I've never watched Game of Thrones.
Let me just say this. I don't watch Game of Thrones, but.
It's a big, it's huge,
start,
it's huge.
If you start, that's
it's
what
huge.
She said. That's what
it's
she
huge.
Said. That's what she said.
Throne
that's what she
is
said.
Huge. Yeah, they've got dragons.
Yeah, that's what she said. Look, now, if you start watching it, though.
You get hooked.
My goodness. You can't stop.
Power
is
the
fantastic.
Best.
Fantastic.
Did you guys see that recent video with the guy, the new lawyer? the black dude.
I've been trying not to watch any trailers, anything Power.
So you can get it at one time.
So
and
when
watch
I
it
get
all.
A chance to binge watch it, I haven't seen anything.
Is it on Netflix?
No. It's on the Fire Stick, though.
Oh, it's on the Fire Stick?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but this
I know somebody who has one.
Right. So go to your nearest Fire Stick.
I don't have one myself, but I know.
Yeah, but they're trying to say, you know, it was a little joke because the guy's all kind of, you know, sticking his tongue out and talking a little light. Like, you know, he don't want Tasha. He wants Ghost.
Oh, I heard that.
I have no idea what you're talking about. I know Ghost.
I didn't see it. I didn't watch it. I read the comments and the commentary about it, but I didn't watch the video because, again, I'm trying to avoid all things Power because I don't want to be clued in.
Yeah.
When I get a chance to binge watch it, I will be... Ready. It'll be like I'm seeing it for the first time and didn't hear anything about it.
Well,
however.
They're insinuating this man is sweet.
Yes.
I'm sure that is
what they're insinuating.
There's no show that doesn't have a sweet guy on it. They all
but he's
you
not,
have
no,
to
he's not
have
on the show.
That.
He's
this
not on the show.
Oh, he's not on the show.
No, Power doesn't have any sweetheart.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That's the only show on TV that doesn't have somebody
Power's
gay.
Power's hardcore, man.
Okay.
Right.
All right, good.
He's straight on the show. And to me, he plays a very good job. Now, this is the funny part. I commented under the picture like I never thought. I would have knew. Now, one of my gay friends was like,
he called it out. Oh,
yeah. I thought so.
Where's my cousin Trey when you need him?
Here we go.
Yeah. So your friend said he was definitely, he could tell even, well, he ain't acting that good, huh?
He is on the show, but not in that video. He was like, you know, he should have had on a wig.
Yeah.
All right, what else you got? Power.
Well.
What about Housewives? You watch that, don't you? The Housewives.
I don't watch
that. All the Housewives. They're on a break right now.
I don't watch the Housewives.
And that loving Hip Hop Hollywood is terrible.
I've heard. That's what I've heard.
Yeah,
I've heard
it's
that,
terrible.
Squirrel.
It's
I've heard that the Hollywood's terrible.
Yeah, it's terrible.
I got a question for you, Billy. Mm-hmm. I know we're not. I don't want to go back to it today, but one day we got to talk about some of the, when we were talking about NFL, something we didn't mention, and we're going to have to approach that subject one day.
What is it?
The coons. The coons are coming out left and right in regards to the NFL.
God, you had to open up that can of worms.
Oh, boy.
You're absolutely right, and it's almost pathetic.
Yes.
They need to sit down
and
shut up. If you ain't got nothing constructive to say, but this is what I've said this for years, they will always find a Negro to speak out against the rest
the
of us.
Exactly.
And it's like they've been brainwashed or, you know. But
The overseer.
Mm-hmm. He's the overseer.
Yeah.
Or
and
maybe
I remember
they're getting checks for it.
I remember as a kid watching Martin Luther King and Malcolm X on these on the news shows, you know, and they always had a black man across the table and the white guy's in the middle.
Yeah,
Dr. King's
do.
On one side and Uncle's on the other side, and he's just trying to I never understood at that time, especially when the civil rights thing was going on,
right.
I couldn't understand why somebody would be speaking against Dr. King or Malcolm X, and it would always, but as I got older, I understood what was going on. They got to get another black person to kind of bring the rest of us over there on their side.
Can I just say this?
It's an old trick.
I don't want to stay here long, so I just want
to
say
this. Well,
you brought it up.
We can stay as long.
I'm not trying to stay here at all.
I'm just trying to say, in regards to your show, because if it was what up there,
just make your point.
My point is, they always do that when it comes to
that.
We always do that when it comes to black people.
Yes.
But when it's a topic against white people, every now and then you'll get a white guy that's on our side, but very rarely.
Very simple. They did
but
it.
Every single topic
they
in
did it just
to
recently
black.
On CNN. Eric Michael Dyson. Eric Michael Dyson was talking. They had this black lady who I've never seen before just promoting Trump. Supporting Trump.
Everything.
I was like, what is wrong with
every
this woman?
Every time you turn on CNN, you're going to see
it. It was an Omarosa.
And again, no, it was somebody I've never seen before.
No,
and
they got a bunch of them.
Again, they will always find a Negro to come out and speak against black people. They
always.
Do it all the time.
They
nothing
did.
Has changed. Like I said, from Dr. King all the way to now, nothing has changed. So don't fall for the okey-doke.
Thank you.
Kind of like on the Roland Martin show when... Doctor, what is his name?
Oh, I know who you're talking about. I know who you're talking about.
John Umar. Dr. Umar Johnson was on there. And then you got Roland Martin in the middle. You got the one black guy that was backing up Umar. You had the black woman who was attacking Umar, and you had the black guy that was attacking, and they're basically trying to make it seem like, you know, oh, it's not that bad, and, you know, like he was delirious. And it was crazy. It was absolutely crazy.
Yeah, it's amazing.
It's amazing, man. That's why we ain't going to never go no further. We ain't going to never go forward. We're still searching, baby. Radio, we get a little heated sometimes, but you know, you gotta, that's what we're here for. Sometimes you just have
gotta
to express
do what you
yourself.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
Now, before we go, we gotta have a little fun, and Squirrel has found something about the Colonel Sanders.
I apologize. That.
What?
I apologize for bringing that up.
No, man. Hey, look. It has to be said. But let's talk about the Colonel in these last few minutes.
Black
everybody
people
loves
coons.
Chicken.
Speaking of black people and coons, let's talk about some fried chicken.
Oh, my God.
The best fried chicken in the world, KFC.
So I was looking for facts.
Or is it Popeye's?
It's KFC for me.
Or is it Church's?
It's KFC for me. Church's second.
Church's got Jurassic chickens. Anyway.
Oh, my God.
Pterodactyl wings. There's got to be something wrong.
So we were debating whether or not the original Colonel Sanders was black. And I was trying I said yes.
I said, well, the chicken is. Whoever cooked that chicken, they got a black man back there cooking that chicken.
So I was trying to look up facts.
I had never heard
something
that.
To back it up. And I didn't find it. I didn't find anything to back it up, so my claim was false.
As usual.
I'm going to say. Whatever. Damn it. But I did find some interesting facts.
What did you find while you were searching?
I found some interesting facts about Colonel Sanders.
Interesting facts about Colonel Sanders, Becky. This should be fun.
About the real Colonel Sanders.
About the real Colonel Sanders.
I got to hear this one.
Number one. Sanders opened his first restaurant inside a gas station.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Yes, it was a Shell station.
A roadside station, if I recall correctly, because he just had a little business, thing going.
In 1930.
Yeah. Making frying up some chicken.
In Corbin, Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
Number two. He wounded a business rival in a deadly shootout.
What? Wait a minute. What?
Yes.
Okay, break that down, brother.
Yes.
Tell us.
Okay. He was painting advertisements on barns and stuff, barn signs around town.
That was a big thing back then.
Well, mm-hmm. There was a guy who owned a standard station who would paint over it because he didn't want people going to the Shell station because for him, it was advertising his competitor.
Makes sense.
Well, he heard about it.
Who, the Colonel?
The Colonel heard about it, so he grabbed a
and
couple
Colonel
guys.
Colonel said, who the hell is painting over my signs?
Painting over my sign again. So he grabbed a couple of guys from the Shell, uh-huh. And they went over to confront the guy.
Uh-huh.
And the guy came out with a pistol.
Uh-oh.
And killed one of the Shell guys.
Damn. Over a sign?
And Colonel Sanders shot back.
Oh my God.
Oh, the Colonel had one on his hip, huh?
Colonel Sanders shot back and shot the guy in the shoulder.
Wow.
Jeff Matthews was the guy's name. He went to prison for 18 years, and Colonel Sanders got off because it was self-defense.
Sure.
So people really do go crazy over chicken.
The Colonel was gangster. Number three.
Sanders served in the military, but was an honorary colonel.
Oh, wait a minute. In the military, he was an honorary colonel?
Yes.
Really?
In other words, he was not really a colonel in the military.
Obviously.
Right? It's like an honorary degree.
I wonder how he became an honorary colonel. It probably came years later.
But he falsified his birth date in order to enlist in the U.S. Army in 1906.
He was 12.
Pretty much 16. Know. 16.
Yeah, that's when young men go in.
Yeah,
16,
he was 16.
15, 16.
But he falsified because I think you were supposed to be 18, right? So he served in Cuba for several months before his honorary discharge in 1935.
Cuba.
Number four. The colonel delivered babies and practiced law before hitting it big in fast food.
Wait a minute. What? He delivered. So wait a minute. He was a doctor and a lawyer? He delivered babies?
He had
babies?
An extremely varied resume, okay, before
Sounds
finding
like.
Success.
Okay.
Frying chicken. And he was in his 60s when he started KFC.
Okay. I know he was late in life. I knew that. Yeah.
As a young man, he toiled as a farmhand, a streetcar conductor, before working for railroad companies across the South. Aspiring to be the next Clarence Darrow, Sanders studied law by correspondence and practiced in Justice of Peace courts in Arkansas until a courtroom brawl with a client derailed his legal career.
He didn't shoot nobody in the courtroom, did he?
No, but he beat up his client.
He beat up his own client.
He beat up his own client.
Damn it, let me do this. I know what I'm doing. No, you don't. You're going to get me locked up. You shut up.
Yes. And the colonel wasn't no joke. So number five, his first Kentucky Fried Chicken franchise was in Utah.
In Utah, of all places. But he's from Tennessee, right?
Yes, Salt Lake City, Utah.
Interesting.
Number six. After selling the company, the colonel sued the KFC, the new Kentucky Fried Chicken, for $122 million.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
The reason being, he was still there, the face of the company.
Well, at that point, you couldn't, you know.
But he said the food was horrible.
Oh, they messed up his recipe.
The gravy was slop. He wanted no part of it.
But my face is on it, so.
He started a competitor.
Oh, really?
Yes.
What was it called?
The competitor was called the Colonel's Ladies Dinner House.
Oh, Lord, that'll never work. You can't put that on a sign.
Exactly. It was in Shelbyville, Kentucky.
Okay.
And they tried to block it. They tried to block him from doing that.
Of course.
And so he filed suit against him for $122 million. And they settled out of court for $1 million.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, he didn't want much, did he?
Right.
I'm wondering, how far along was he with the franchise when he sold it? Because it was established, apparently, when they bought it. It had to be some value to it if they bought it.
It was in 1964 when he sold it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It was still kind of on the come up then. It wasn't as big as it is
now,
of
4 years later, he started his
company. He was mad.
Yeah, he was pissed off.
A lot of people do that. The McDonald's. Basically, Ray Kroc stole it from the McDonald brothers, and then he opened up
McDowell's.
Because they couldn't use their own name. He put a McDonald's right across the street from their restaurant. They only had the one original restaurant, and then made them take their name off of their restaurant and shut them down.
That's good.
No, it ain't good.
That's wonderful.
He's a crook.
That is what
Ray
Kroc
is a crook. Next, what number are we
That's
on?
That's a crocker. Anyway, number seven.
Number seven?
Sanders swore like a sailor.
I bet he did. They took his restaurant from him.
He may have appeared the epitome of a Southern gentleman, but his language was notoriously salty.
My dear, your chicken is a bit salty.
Yeah, you mother. Number eight.
He was a sailor, wasn't he?
The last one, number eight. The colonel supposedly cursed a Japanese baseball team.
Cursed them? Cursed them out?
No, he just cursed them.
He put a curse on him?
The curse of the colonel.
Oh, kind of like the Chicago Cubs.
Perhaps not surprising for a man prone to cursing. But legend has it that Sanders put a hex on the Hanshin Tigers after the baseball team's joyous fans celebrated an 85 championship by tossing his statue, taken from a local KFC, into the Osaka River. The team's subsequent championship drought has been blamed on the curse of the colonel. And they have still, to this day, not won another championship.
Wow. Ain't that something?
Even after he died in 2009.
They still have not won. That's a curse.
Eight things about the colonel that you didn't know.
The colonel was an interesting guy.
But he ain't black.
Hey, that's going to do it for Billy T. Detroit Radio, the podcast, for this segment, Rocky Road.
Yes. Thank you guys for tuning in. Shout out to Miss Rihanna Lanie, happy birthday. Rihanna.
All right. I love Rihanna.
I want to say happy birthday to TJ's mama.
TJ's mama?
Yes, yo. TJ's mama.
Mrs. Smith, much love. We'll be over there for some of that rum cake.
Absolutely.
Right. Rum cake. Jesus.
Hey, thanks so much for listening, and we'd like to hear from you. If you enjoy the show, if you don't like the show, well, then why the hell did you listen? And but leave a comment below
yes.
if you're watching or listening on Facebook. Yes. We appreciate it, all right?
Yes, follow me on Rocky Road Productions, LLC Porch Talk, Instagram.
Boom shakalaka. And you can check me out on the What Up Dope Show. So it's facebook.com/What Up Dope Show.
All right, there it is. I'm Billy T. Detroit. You already know. Peace, y'all.
Thank you for listening to the Billy T. Detroit radio broadcast. Follow me on social media at Billy T. Detroit.